artificial propagation. Artificial vegetative propagation includes all the human-developed methods of propagating and growing plants, which are mainly of horticultural use. The focus is on ornamental, flower-yielding, and fruit-yielding plants. Some common methods of artificial propagation include cutting, that is stem cutting, grafting, budding, and layering. The latest techniques include hybridization, micropropagation, and biotechnological methods. Grafting, joining a part, that is stem or a bud, of a living plant to another, causing it to grow as a part of the second plant. It is useful in inducing the special traits or characters of one plant into the other. For example, rose and fruit yielding plants like mango, guava, peaches, etc. Types of grafting: chicken grafting and bird grafting. Grafting involves the joining of different segments of two different plants of the same species. Grafting is usually done in the spring and involves the collecting a small branch called second wood. In grafting, the cambium layers of the two different segments are aligned and grow together. Budding or bud grafting. Bud grafting is a faster, easier and less messy than other form of grafting. Cambium layers do not need to be aligned. Bud grafting is done from early July through early August. This method uses a newly developed latent bud taken from under a live leaf. Grafting. Grafting is a process of connecting the two plant parts together in such a way that they will unite and continue to grow as one plant. There are numerous uses for grafting, that is to create the new plants, to create the dwarf plant, to increase the hardiness, to increase the disease resistance, to change the natural plant form. The main reason for grafting is to asexually propagate the plants that are difficult by other methods. It is often used in the production of orchard trees, shade trees and roses. There are several grafting methods commonly used by propagators. Cleft grafting is often used to join a small cycle to a larger stalk. It is usually done in the late winter. The branch or a tree is cut straight across with a knife or grafting tool. A split or silt is made in the cut end of the limb or root stalk. Next, a second piece 3 to 5 long with one or two buds is cut and the end sharpened into a thin wedge. Bark grafts. Bark grafts are similar to cleft grafts in that they join smaller cycle wood to larger root stalk. It is done in early spring when the bark easily separates from the wood along the cambium layer. The bark grafting is used to propagate the fruit, ornamental and shade trees. Layering. Layering causes the root to develop on the shoot that is still attached to the plant, parent plant. The stem is not cut from the main plant until it has rooted. Simple layering is done by bending a branch to the ground and burying a portion of it while the tip remains uncovered. Treatment with rooting hormone is helpful. Layering is done in the early spring while plants are still dominant or in late summer on wood that has not become the wooden. Other types of layering include compound, trench and mound layering. Air layering. Air layering can be used to propagate the large overgrown house plant such as the rubber plant. Woody ornamentals such as the camellia, magnolia, oleander and holly can be propagated by the air layering. For optimum rooting, make air layer in the spring on the shoot produced during the previous season or in the mid to late summer on the shoot from the current season growth. For the woody plant, a stem of a pencil-sized diameter or larger are best. Choose an area just below the node and remove the leaves and twigs on the stem 3 to 4 inches above and below this point. Division. Division is the cutting or a breaking up of a cron or a clump of sugars into the segments. Each segment must have a bud and some roots. The segments are replanted and grow into the new plants identical to the parent. Most perennials should be lifted and divided when they become overgrown and begin to lose the vigor. The vigorous growth in most perennials occur on the outer segment of the clump. In some cases, outside the segment of the plant can be removed and replanted without disturbing the rest of the plant. The good rule of the thumb is to divide the fall and flowering perennials in spring and spring and summer flowering perennials in fall. Carefully dig the plant, loosening the root and lifting the plant from the soil. Split apart the main clump with two spades of fork for shock with a shovel or hatchet if the clump is firmly meshed. Bulbs and cones. Bulbs can be propagated by removing the small bulblet or offset that form at the base of the parent bulb. This small bulb takes 2 or 3 years to mature into the plant that flowers. Many leaves can be multiplied by removing the scales from the mature bulb.